Hi, I'm Tom Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org. Choosing the right logging configuration can make the difference between finding a performance issue during development or suffering from it on production. But it can also create an overhead that slows down your application. You need to decide what you need and configure your system accordingly. I therefore prefer to use two different configurations for development and production. A development configuration should log enough internal information to understand the database interactions, see the number of executed queries, and check the SQL statements. In production, you want to get the best performance. You don't need any internal information. A production configuration should log as few messages as possible and avoid any overhead to get the best performance. Before we talk about the different logging settings, let's have a quick look at the logging frameworks supported by Hibernate. Since version 4.0, Hibernate uses the JBoss logging library to write messages to a log file. This library is a logging bridge that integrates different frameworks. You can decide which of the frameworks here on the slide you want to use for your application. You just need to add your preferred framework to your class path, and the JBoss logging library will pick it up. If there are multiple frameworks available, the one with the highest priority will be chosen. I prefer Log4j and will use it for the examples in this video. The concepts and log categories are the same for all frameworks, but the names of the log level might be different if you use a different framework. As all applications and frameworks, Hibernate writes log messages in various categories and log levels. The categories group log messages for specific topics, like executed SQL statements or cache interactions. You can see some of the most important log categories here on the slide. The names of the log levels are defined by your logging framework and define the amount and granularity of the log messages. You can assign a log level to each category. If you do not define log level for a specific category, it will inherit the level from its parent category. Okay, let's finally talk about my recommendations for a development configuration. The main goal is to get useful internal information about the database interactions. Hibernate is doing a lot of things for you in the background, and that makes it easy to forget that you are still working with the database. But if you want to make sure that your application will perform as expected, you need to check the number of executed queries and their SQL statements. To get this information, you need to set the log level of the org.hibernate.sql category to debug, and I also prefer to activate Hibernate statistics to get a summary of the most important metrics at the end of the session. Let's jump into the IDE and check which information you get with these settings. Here you can see the log4j configuration I described on the last slide. I activate the logging of SQL statements and their bind parameters. And I also activated the Hibernate statistics module in the persistence.xml file. Let's run this simple test case and have a look at the log output. It just executes this query to select the author entity with a given ID. You can see the log messages here. This is the SQL statement Hibernate generated for my JPQL query, and this is the binding of the query parameter. The following lines show the binding of the query result. And down here you can see the session metrics collected by the Hibernate statistics component. Hibernate used one JDBC statement to perform one query and didn't use the second level cache. When you use this logging configuration in your project, you should pay special attention to the number of executed queries. It can help you to find N+1 select issues before they cause problems in production. Okay, that's all about the development configuration. Let's talk about my recommendation for production. My recommended production configuration is simple. As long as you don't need to analyze an issue in production, you should log as less information as possible. You do that by setting all Hibernate-related log categories to error. You should also make sure to deactivate the Hibernate statistics component. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate 5. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below.